50 years ago this Sunday night, Martians invaded Earth. It wasn't real, only a drama on CBS radio. But to many of the 6 million people listening, it sounded very real and frightening. They heard a ballroom music program interrupted by a news bulletin of a Martian landing in New Jersey. Many didn't hear the disclaimers that it was just some Halloween fun.
It was the night before Halloween, 1938, 8 p.m. 23-year-old Orson Welles and his Mercury Theater presented a radio play based on H.G. Wells' novel, The War of the Worlds. John Houseman was the co-producer.
Within 10 minutes, I realized that the switchboards were deluged with complaints, calls, and that hell had broken loose.
Historians believe more than a million people took the broadcast literally.
We thought the world was coming to an end because of the Martians.
People were running and screaming and knocking on doors.
They were all excited, and one was saying to another, "Is this the end of the world?"
At a news conference the next day, Orson Welles defended the hoax.
I'm extremely surprised to learn that a story which has become familiar to children should have had such an immediate and profound effect upon radio listeners.
Suddenly, you realize that the spoken word through radio was able to affect the feeling, the emotions of the entire world.
The man who wrote the radio play, The War of the Worlds, was Howard Koch, a young writer who would go from radio to Hollywood, where his credits would include co-authorship of the film classic Casablanca. Howard Koch is with us this morning. Good morning. I see you are holding there in front of you an original script of the historic radio broadcast. It's been on display at Sotheby's here in New York. They're going to be auctioning it in December. It is fragile. It has some notes scribbled on it. Those are your notes. There are some Orson Welles handwriting in the inside as well. I thought they confiscated all of those.
All but this. This was in my apartment. I didn't go down to the studio during the broadcast. Mm-hmm. And they came in, the police came in and took all the scripts they could get their hands on in the studio. But of course they didn't know that I had this one up on 72nd Street, and it's become now, I guess, the only one that I know of.
Amazing. They came to you and they said, H.G. Wells has this incredible story, write it into a radio play. How many, you had what, 6 days?
Yes, and the way Orson wanted it, I could use very little from the H.G. Wells story except the idea of the invasion, mm-hmm. and description of the Martian machines and their heat wave.
Right.
But the rest of it, he wanted in news bulletin form, and then first person singular and contemporary. And I said, but Orson, this is impossible to do in 6 days. That's original script. And Orson never brooked that kind of defiance, mm-hmm. and he said, "Do it. That's all." So I went back and started on it, and I realized I needed a map because I had to lay out a campaign between mm-hmm. us and the Martians the way Orson wanted.
Sure.
And I had been up to the country. See my father, Kingston, New York, and coming down, I went through a portion of New Jersey.
Mm-hmm.
And so I stopped at a gas station, and they gave me New Jersey map. So when I came back to my apartment, I spread out the map on the table, closed my eyes, put the pencil down.
And that's where the Martians landed.
That was Grover's Mill.
Yeah. Now, you worked tirelessly on the script for 6 days.
Yes.
Is it true you had no idea when you woke up the next day that after the radio broadcast that all this furor had been created by what you had written?
Not in the least. They had tried to reach me during the night, but I was so tired I didn't wake up. And the way I found out was I was going down. I had one half morning off before the next assignment, and that was a chance to get a haircut. So I walked down 72nd Street, and I heard passers-by saying words like war, invasion, so on. And I rushed into the barber shop and I said, "What's going on? Hitler made a move. We're in war or something." And he laughed and held up the morning paper.
And there it was.
And there it was, Martian invasion, play, Panic's Nation, or words to that effect.
Yeah.
Well, very odd moment in my life.
Howard, thanks very much for coming and joining us this morning.
Oh, thank
you. Appreciate it. To remember that 1938 War of the Worlds and 1988 war will be broadcast, and Faith has that story.